Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. At the time when the world was witnessing the birth of many great a'immah, and the ulama of hadith were busy traveling the world in search of ahadith, and you had the likes of Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan and Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahumallah, there was another famous and bright star that belonged to that galaxy of Hanafi muhaddithin. That star was Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah. Imam Ali ibn Abdullah ibn Ja'far ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was born in Basra in Iraq in the year 161 after Hijrah, 11 years after the passing of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, but he lived during the time of the many students of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. His family hails from Medina, hence why he is known as Ibn al-Madini. Normally though, people from Medina are known as being Madani, but this title of Madini stuck, and Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah became famously known by it, that today, if we talk of Ibn al-Madini, then only one person comes to mind, the great Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah. Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah came from a pious and noble family, as his father Imam Abdullah ibn Ja'far rahimahullah was himself a muhaddith, and his grandfather used to narrate from Imam Abdul Rahman ibn al-Qasim, who was the great-grandson of Hazrat Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. So coming from a home of piety and virtue, Imam Ibn al-Madini rahimahullah began studying the deen from a very early age. First under his father, and then to the ulama from around the Muslim world, traveling to the various towns within Iraq, as well as to Yemen and Medina and elsewhere. Imam Ibn al-Madini rahimahullah's relentless desire and passion for hadith led him to become one of the greatest ulama of hadith of his time. Such was the greatness of Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah that Imam Abdul Rahman ibn Mahdi rahimahullah, who was a senior to Imam ibn al-Madini, he would say that Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah is the most knowledgeable person in hadith. If this was not enough of a praise, then perhaps greater than this is the praise that Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah had for Imam Ali ibn al-Madini. Now the thing was that Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah was not just a teacher of Imam Ali ibn al-Madini. He was in fact one of the main teachers and one that had the biggest influence on Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah. And it is this Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah who said that he learned more from his student Imam Ali ibn al-Madini than what Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah learned from him. Now when you know the rank that Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah had, then you will realize just how much of a praise this is. There is a hadith wherein Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam spoke about how a time will come when the people will travel seeking knowledge, and they won't find anyone more knowledgeable than the alim of Medina. The ulama are almost all in agreement that this hadith was referring to Imam Malik ibn Anas rahimahullah. But there were some ulama who felt that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was actually making reference to Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah. That's how much knowledge Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahimahullah had, that the ulama could feel that about him. And this Imam Sufyan ibn Uyayna is saying that he learned more from his student than what his student had learned from him. This is the type of praise that the teachers and seniors of Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah had for him. But even if a person were to look at the students of Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah, you find the same thing as well. One of the most famous students of Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was the great Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. And Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, being as famous and as knowledgeable as he was, he would say that he never feels small when knowledge is concerned in the presence of anyone, besides Imam Ali ibn al-Madini. This was said despite the great knowledge that Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah possessed, but the knowledge that Imam ibn al-Madini rahimahullah possessed was even more, that even this great Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah used to always feel out of his depth. Imam Ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was a close companion of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah together with Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah. They studied together under Imam Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan rahimahullah. As a result, these three ulama used to be in close connection with each other, as they would attend the classes of hadith together. One of the ulama of hadith described these three a'imma and said that of the three, Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah had written the most hadith. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah had the most understanding of the hadith. And Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah had the most knowledge about the hadith and its ilal. Each of the a'imma excelled in every field, but they sort of also had a topic that they tended to focus on and specialize in. For Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah, that topic was ilalul hadith, which is the hidden defects that may be found in a hadith that from the outset it may appear to be authentic. This is a science that requires a great deal of in-depth knowledge, and this is what Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah specialized in and was instrumental in the creation of the science itself. This is beside the fact that Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was actually involved in the formulation of the laws relating to the science of al-jarh wa ta'dil as well. Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was also a prolific author. The ulama have mentioned that Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah was the author of around 200 kitabs, most of which have sadly not made it through the ages to reach us today. But the ulama that did have access to it said that some of the books were written on topics that had, as at that time, not been written on before. And what's more is that up until this day, a book hasn't been written on the same topic that can surpass the ones written by Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah. Imam Ali ibn al-Madini rahimahullah passed away in Samarrah in Iraq in the year 234 after Hijrah, after spending his life in the service of the deen and the preservation of the ahadith of Rasul Rabbil Alameen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah raise his rank in Jannah and resurrect us with these ulama on the day of Qiyamah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.